The Hudson River, 2 years ago. We had classified intelligence that a new type of metal gear was scheduled for transport. The whole thing stank, but our noses had been out in the cold too long.
The mission objective is to make visual confirmation of the new Metal Gear being transported by that tanker and bring back photographic evidence. But I want you first to go up to the top level of the infrastructure, to the bridge. We need to find out where the tanker is headed.
A little reconnaissance, huh?
There's too much we don't know about this new prototype. Capabilities, deployment method. We don't even know how close it is to completion. If we know where the testing arena is, I can start to draw some reasonable conclusions.
All right, I'll head to the bridge ASAP.
Try to avoid confrontations. Our goal is to collect evidence on Metal Gear development and expose it to the world. It would be best if you could get out of there without alerting anyone.
Don't worry. I know the drill. We're not terrorists.
Very good. Don't you forget that you're part of Philanthropy now, an anti-Metal Gear organization and officially recognized by the UN.
Recognized, but still fringe, Otacon.
All right, let's look at your gear. Your weapon is a tranquilizer gun converted from a Beretta M92F.
M9?
It's a little hard to work with because you have to reload after each shot since the slide locks.
Better than scavenging at the mission site. Good suppressor, too.
The chemical stun will take effect in a few seconds and last for hours. You can take down an elephant with that thing. Check out the laser sighting, too. The effects of the anesthetic round will vary depending on what part of the body is hit. We're talking about a difference of tens of seconds between hitting limbs, chest, or head. As for the equipment, hey, Snake, cigarettes? What's wrong with you?
It's kind of a lucky charm.
You haven't read the Surgeon General's warning, have you? Here's the digital camera. Works almost the same way as your...
They don't look armed.
Hey, Earth to Snake. These are nice upstanding Marines, not terrorists. Don't get caught, you're in stealth mode here.
Sure, and if it comes to that, a little beauty sleep never hurt anyone. By the way, Otacon, are you sure of this intelligence?
Absolutely. Hacked it out of the Pentagon's classified files myself.
No traces?
Oh, please, I'm too good for that.
But this might be a trap. Remember, there's a price on our heads.
You're just being paranoid.
I hope so. Those men, you wouldn't think they were anything but civilians from here.
With all the ships passing on the river and in the harbor, putting uniformed Marines on the deck would be a bad idea. People can get a clear view of the water from Riverside, too.
Russians?
You sure?
No Marine barber touched that head of hair. I'm transmitting a photo. Let's get an ID on him ASAP.
I'm on it.
Looks like the tanker's theirs now. K-60 Kasatka.
Kasatka? Kamov chopper, right? Killer whale.
We need to get a fix on who they are.
The other, I need help.
After the end of World War II, the world was split into two, East and West. This marked the beginning of the era called the Cold War.
Approaching Soviet airspace.
20 minutes to drop off.
Commencing internal depressurization. Equipment check. Arm main parachute.
All right. You ready to go?
Drop zone still showing a high pressure mass. Cav okay.
Good. We've got high visibility.
Cigar. Connecting oxygen hose to interior connector. Put on your mask. Does this panty waist know what he's doing?
Approaching release point.
10 minutes to drop off.
Hey, are you deaf?
He said put out the cigar and put on your mask.
Depressurization complete.
Checking oxygen supply.
6 minutes to drop off. Opening rear hatch.
I've got some important news. The head of the CIA has finally given us the green light for the virtuous mission.
Virtual mission?
No, the virtuous mission. The future of...
in the Soviet mountains, ensure the safety of Sokolov and bring him back to the West. If we don't get Sokolov back before that weapon is complete, we'll be facing a major crisis. The clock is ticking. Once we've confirmed the rescue of Sokolov, stand by at the recovery point. A recovery balloon will be dropped at that point. Helium will be pumped into the balloon to inflate it. The process takes about 20 minutes. Once it's complete, the gunship's arm will latch onto the balloon and pull it up.
The Fulton surface-to-air recovery system. I'm familiar with the theory.
Take it easy. It's been combat-proven.
Do you think Sokolov is up to it?
The shock will be less than during a parachute jump, and the arm can handle up to 500 pounds.
So you're planning on going over the border in a single combat talent?
She's equipped with two 6-barrel 20mm Vulcan cannons, as well as two 40mm machine guns.
Sounds like she could hold her own against a battalion of tanks.
Even with the fuel in the reserve tank, we're facing a 4-hour time limit. If all goes well, it shouldn't take more than a few hours.
Home in time for dinner.
But if anything goes wrong,
you'll be eating dinner, breakfast,
and all the rest of your meals in the jungle. Do you copy? You're already in enemy territory, and somebody might be listening in. From here on out, we'll be using code names to refer to it.
Snake, where do you think you're going? You can't expect to proceed with the mission without any weapons or equipment. First, you'll need to recover your backpack. It's caught on a tree to the south. Press the action button to climb the tree and retrieve your backpack. Is that clear? I see you've retrieved your backpack, Snake. To equip a weapon...
Snake, try to remember some of the basics of CQC.
Commencing virtuous mission now.